Now, what is 10 factorial? You already are aware now that 10 factorial is the product of all natural numbers starting from 1 up to 10. Alright? So that means, that's the product of all the numbers from 1 to 10. That means whatever prime numbers are there from 1 to 10, only they will appear. Okay. So what are the prime numbers from 1 to 10? 2, 3, 5, 7. What about other numbers? All the other numbers in that range will be a product of some power of 2, 3 or 5 or 7. Alright? Okay. Now, how many multiples of 7 are there from 1 to 10? That you can count directly. You can just read the table of 7 and see how many of those numbers are there from 1 to 10. There is only one number. So that means there is only one multiple of 7 from 1 to 10. Okay. And there is a technical method of counting that number of multiples. I think we have done that in one of the previous sessions. Multiples of 7 from 1 to 10. What do we do? We said that divide the last number by the desired number. So 10 by 7. That comes out to be 1 point something. But as we are counting, we have to take only the complete outcome of this, complete quotient of this. So 10 by 7 is just 1. So that means there is only one multiple of 7. So what we are doing here is, count the number of multiples of that prime factors. That is the first step. There are many further steps also for smaller numbers. Next, 5. How many multiples of 5 are there? What does this mean? M7 means number of multiples of 7. M5 means number of multiples of 5. Out of what? Out of this given range. So if we count normally from 1 to 10, how many numbers would be there? Multiples of 5. So that we can simply count by either by reading the table of 5 or divide 10 by 5. So you get 2. So there are only 2 multiples. So you can actually check 5 and 10. That means after factorization, there will be only 2 5s in this product. So 5 ka power will be 2. Now let's count the number of multiples of 3. What is the number of multiples of 3? Again, we can divide 10 by 3. What do we get? We get 3 point something. That means only 3. Now this thing will start happening from 3 on downwards, in fact. Look at the multiples of 3. 3, 6, 9. Now out of these 3, 3 and 6 have only one 3. No, 3 is just 3 into 1. Well, 6 is 3 into 2. Whereas 9 is 3 into 3. So 9 is not only a multiple of 3, it is also a power of 3. Okay. So every 9 will consist of 2 3s. Right? So I have already included. So when I say number of multiples of 3 is 3, that means we have counted this 3, we have counted this 3, we have counted this 3. We have still not counted this 3. Okay? Now this 3 is coming because of 9, and 9 which is a square of 3. Alright, so 9 is a power of 3. Now, whenever this situation happens, the division has to continue to be continued further. Meaning, count the number of multiples of 3. Check if there is any higher power of 3 which lies in this interval. That is 9. So, count the number of multiples of 9 also. So, 10 by 9. Alright, so I hope you can understand this extra counting is done to include this particular 3. So, now, how will you find the total number of 3s finally? So these 3 multiples of 3 and this one more. So total there will be 4 3's in that product. Okay. So what did we do? We just divided the last number by the desired number 3 and any other power of 3 if it lies in the given interval. See, understand. For 5, the next power of 5 would come at 5 squared, which is 25. 25 was not there from 1 to 10. So we do not bother about it. 7 squared, that is 49. Right? So the first multiple of 7, which has 2 7s, will come at 49. That is not a part of 1 to 10. So we ignored it. Alright? For 3, it happens here. Okay. There is another thing that we can do. What we did was, we found the number of multiples of 3. That was 10 by 3. We got how much? 3. Now, we have to go back and divide 10 by 9 again. So can I say that we have already divided 10 by 3 and we have got 3? So just divide this 3 by 3 once more. It should give you the same outcome. Alright. So 10 by 9. To find 10 by 9. What we are saying is, divide 10 by 3. You get some number. That will obviously be smaller. This thing will be really useful for larger numbers. Okay. So already we have divided by 3 once. Okay. We want to divide that original number by 9. So whatever you have got, divide this by 3 again. Okay. So if you divide some number by 3 successively, automatically division happens for 9. Okay. So, we have got 1. So, total number of 3's present in this product will be 3 plus 1, add them. So 3 plus 1, 4. Okay. Let me explain once more. What you are doing is, you are just putting all the numbers from 1 to 10 on a table. Okay. Go to every number and check if it has a 3 as a factor. Take it out, put it in your pocket. Alright. But make sure that you take in only 1 3 from any number. Alright. So if you start from 1, 1 does not have a 3. 2 does not have a 3. Okay. 3 has a 3. So take that 3, put it in your pocket. So you have 1 3 now. Then 4 does not have a 3. 5 does not have a 3. 6 has a 3. Take another 3, put it in your pocket. So now you have total 2 3s. Okay. Go back. 7 does not have a 3. 8 does not have a 3. Now 9 has 2 3s. But as I said earlier, initially you just take 1 3 from wherever it is available. So out of 9, let's take just 1 3. So now you have 3 3s. Alright. So this we counted on the basis of a multiple of 3. Okay. Now go back and see from the remaining numbers. Is there any factor 3 still available? Obviously, only those numbers which had multiple 3s, that means higher power of 3, that means 3 square onwards, only they would have 3 now. You can see, 3 wala 3 we have already taken, 6 wala 3 we have taken, 9 ka 1 3 we have taken. So there is another 3 that is remaining, that is only for a multiple of 9. Now there is only one multiple of 9, that this one shows that there is only one multiple of 9. Okay, so take, now go back and check the multiples of 9, there is only one of them. Obviously, out of those 3s of 9, those 2 3's of 9, 1 3 is already being taken here. There is another 3 that you take. So now you have total 4. Now see if there is any other 3 available. Now there is no 3 available in this. So total there are 4 3's. So 3 to the power 4. Let's do it for 2. For 2 it will be further longer. Okay. I'll do it for 2 here. How many multiples of 2 are there from 1 to 10? So 10 by 2. How much do we get? 5. So what are we doing? We are putting all the numbers from 1 to 10 and we are taking out 2's. So there are 5 multiples of 2's. We take 1 2 from every number. Alright, so we have already got 5 2's with us. Now go back and check if there is any number which has a 2. Which numbers would have 2 now? Only those numbers would have 2 now which were actually a multiple of 4. Okay. The numbers which were only a multiple of 2 would not have any 2 available with them now. The numbers which were a multiple of 4, they still have a 2. Okay. So now what do you do? Count the number of multiples of 4. And how would you do that? Divide 10 by 4. Okay. But following this logic, if you already divided 10 by 2 and you have got 5, so just divide 5 by another 2. Avoid cancellation because we only, every time we have to get integer number. Now, so 5 by 2 will be 2.5, but we have to take only integer. Okay, so what is the meaning of this 2? So initially we took 5 2's from all the numbers wherever it was available. Now go back and we check multiples of 4 and we take 1 2 from each of them. There are only 2 multiples of 4. So from these 2, like 4 and 8 we already know. So we take 1 2 from each. Now again go back and see if there is a multiple of 8. Why? We have taken 2 once, then we have taken 2 once more. Now we are going for the third round. Which number will have a 2 still available with it? Only those numbers which are multiples of 2 cube. That means multiples of 8. So check how many numbers are there from 1 to 10 which are multiples of 8. So what do you have to do? Divide 10 by 8. Or you already have divided 10 by 2 twice to get this 2. Divide this 2 by another 2. So that will complete the division and that gives us 1. Then you can do direct division or less. This will be faster and simpler. You know, in short, I can say, divide 10 by 2, you get 5. Divide 5 by 2, you get 2. Divide 2 by 2, you get 1. So add all these quotients. That will give you the total number of 2's available in this factorial 10. Which will be how much? It will be 2 to the power 8. I repeat for 3 and then for 2. What you have to do is, if you want to find the power of 3 in a factorial, divide the given number by 3. What do you get? You get 3. Divide it again by 3. What do you get? You get 1. Then add the quotients. So go on dividing till the time division is possible. It's not 1. It is till the time division is possible. For example, suppose we got a number which is more than 3 yet. We divide it again. And go on doing that. And then you add all of these numbers. So if you add them, you get 4. That is the power of 3. Similarly here, divide 10 by 2. You get 5. Then again divide 5 by 2, you get 2. Remember, you have to take only integers at every instant because you have to count the number of multiples. You have to count the number of 2. You can't have a half 2. You can't have a 1/4 2. Right? You'll always have a complete 2. So that means you take only the integer numbers. Then this again, is it still divisible by 2? Yes. So divide once more. So we get 1. Is it still divisible? No. So just leave it here. So add this 5, 2 and 1. Add all the quotients. At every stage, whatever quotients you got, add them. So you get 2 to the power 8. Right? For 5 and 7, we did not need to do that because 5 square is not there from 1 to 10. 7 square is not there from 1 to 10. Alright? So this is for 10 factorial. Now let's try the same thing for bigger numbers. Let's say, for example, if I have next number, let's take 20 factorial. If we have 20 factorial, what is the first thing that we need to do? 20 factorial is all the natural numbers from 1 to 20. The product of all the natural numbers from 1 to 20. Okay. So what are the prime numbers which are there from 1 to 20? Prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19. Okay. Now what is half of 20? 10. So 10 ka double is 20. That means 11 ka double will not fall in this range. So any number above 10 will have only one multiple in this. So what are any, is there any prime number above 10, 11, 13, 17 or 19? So for all these numbers, there is going to be only one multiple, right? So 19 to the power 1, 17 to the power 1, 13 to the power 1, 11 to the power 1. Okay. Now 7. How many multiples of 7 are there? So 20 up to 20. How many multiples of 7 are there? So just divide 20 by 7. Remember, you don't have to do approximation. So do not take the nearest number. You have to take the complete numbers available. Right, so 20 by 7, however close it is to 3, you can't take 3, you have to take 2. Or you just count the multiple of 7. Or you just read the multiple of table of 7. So 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14. Right, so there will be only 2 7s. 7 threes are 21. 21 is not there a part of this number. Okay, so only 2 7s will be there. How about 5? Let's see. One ways you can directly count multiples of 5. So 5, 10, 15, 20. Only 4 5s will be there. Okay, so 5 from 5, 10 is 5 to 2, so 1 5 from there, 15 is 5 to 3, so 1 5 from there, 20 is 5 to 4, so 1 5 from there, so total 5 raised to the power 4. Or you could have simply divided 20 by 5. Okay, so till now there is no prime number, the square of which has been included in this range from 1 to 20. Now what about 3? Let's see, 3 square, 3 cube, what is 3 square? 9, so there will be multiples of 9 available. Then 3 cube, 27, that will not be available. So what do we have to do? We have to count multiples of 3, multiples of 3 square. Okay, and how do we do that? We divide 20 by 3 to get 6. We get 6.66, but we take only complete numbers. Then again divide this 6 by 3. Remember, we have to divide 20 by 9. So instead of doing that, divide this number by 3 again. So what do you get? 2. Add this 6 and 2. So total will be 6 plus 2, that is 8. Okay, then what is the power of 2? So divide 20 by 2, what do you get? 10. Then divide 10 by 2, what do you get? 5. Divide 5 by 2, you get 2. Okay, then divide 2 by 2, you get 1. Add all the quotients. So 10 plus 5 plus 2 plus 1, which is 18. So 2 raised to the power 18 is the power of 2 in 20 factorial. Let's do it for 25 factorial. What are the prime numbers on 25? 1 to 25? 2. 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23. That's it. Right? So 23, there is only one multiple. From 1 to 25, 19, there is only one multiple. 17, there is only one multiple. 13, there is only one multiple. For 11, there will be two multiples. 11 ones are 11, 11 twos are 22. So, 2 11s would be there, so 11 squared. 7, 7 you can see, only 3 multiples. 7 threes are 21. 5, what about 5? Now see, 5 square is included in this. Okay, so 25 divided by 5, how much do we get? 5. Then 5, is it divisible by 5? Yes, so divide once more, you get 1. So 5 plus 1, that is equal to 6. So there will be total power of 5, that is 6 in this. You can actually count also. So 5, 10, 15, 20. So all of these 4 numbers will have 1 5 each. Then 25 has 2 5s each. 2 5s in it, that is 5 square. So total 5s will be 6. Then 3. So divide 25 by 3, this is 8. Divide 8 by 3, this is 2. Is 2 further divisible by 3? No. So stop it here. Okay. So 8 plus 2. Remember, 8 by 3 would be actually 2.6, but you have to take only the whole number. So 8 plus 2, that is 10 here. Now what about 2? So 25 by 2, that is 12. It's 12.5, but we take only whole number. 12 by 2, that is 6. 6 by 2, that is 3. 3 by 2, that is 1. So add 12, 6, 3, 1. That will give you the total power of 2 in 25 factorial. So it is 2 to the power, add this, 12 plus 6, 18, 21, 22. So it is 2 to the power 22. 50 factorial and 100 factorial. Now 50 factorial. What are the prime numbers from 1 to 50? So 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43, 47. So there are total 15 prime numbers. Right. So out of these, what are the prime factors which will have power 1? Obviously, half of 50 is 25. So above 25, every number will appear only once. So those prime numbers will have exactly 1 power. I'll repeat. Above 25, because 25 2's are is 50. 26 2's are is 52. So above 25, any prime number will have power 1, because it's only 1 multiple of that number will be there in this range. Then 23. Read the table or divide 50 by 23. So you get 2 times 19 3's are 57, 19 2's are 38, 17 3's are 51. Please understand, 51 is not included in this. So only 2 multiples of 17. So hence 2 power of 17. 13. 13 3's are 39. So 3. 11 4's are 44. Now 7. You see, 50 by 7 is 7. Why? 7 7's are 49 hota hai. So we get 7 point something, but we take only whole number. Is it divisible by 7? Yes. So once more, so it is equal to 1. So 7 plus 1, that is 8, is the power of 7. Then comes 5. 50 by 5, which is equal to 50 by 5 is 10. 10 by 5 is 2. So total 10 plus 2. Alright. So 10 plus 2, 12 is the power of 5. Then comes 3 and 2. Let me remove this. 3 and 2. What about 3? So 50 divided by 3. That will be 16. 16 divided by 3. That will be 5. 5 by 3. That will be 1. So total 16 plus 5 plus 1. So it is 22 is the power of 3. Okay. Then what about 2? Let's see. 50 divided by 2. That is 25. And then for further 25 we have already done. But divide it again. 25 by 2. That is 12. 12 by 2. That is 6. 6 by 2. That is 3. 3 by 2. That is 1. So the total power of 2 will be the addition of all these numbers. So if you add them, you get 37 plus 6, 43, 46, 47. So 2 raised to the power 47. Okay. Please understand that in the exam, they never ask this complete factorization. But this is a Pandora's box. There can be a question related to any of these prime numbers. So in that case, let's say question is only for 11. So you know that there are only 4 multiples of 11 in this 1 to the 50. That means the power of 11 that will divide factor to 50 is only 4. So, question would be related to only one or two of them, not for all of them. But here, just to understand the process well, we are doing for everything. Okay. Now, let's finally take for 100 factorial.